Hey y'all, welcome to What Chelsea Eats. Thank you so much for joining me today. I wanted to talk to you briefly about a question that I was asked on Monday after the live, and I realized I never did a video ever on food prep, and that's something that I do quite frequently. And I don't do it in a traditional sense, but I wanted to come on and just say, in the first of the year, I plan on doing like some videos where I actually show you what I do as far as food prepping and give you some ideas of what you can do for food prepping. And I know that's not helping you now because I'm not showing you what to do, but I want to just tell you what my thoughts are on it. And I can give you a general overview as to really what I do, what works for me. The bottom line is whatever food prep plan you decide that you're gonna do, it has to work for you. It can't be what I do. It can't be what Sally Joe down the street does or Tamika down the street does. It has to be something that is going to work for you and your lifestyle. So personally, day to day, I prep my meals for the entire day. Unless I know that I'm going to have a really busy day and I won't have time to prep it for the next day, like the following day. So say I'm prepping for today and I know that this day is going to be busy and then I have an early morning the next morning where I won't have time to do any food prep, then I will prep for 2 days. But usually that's the most prep that I usually do. And I want to just tell you the reason I am not doing a food prep video is because I am on my 60-day juice feast and there's no food to prep except for my juices, and I've already done that, so I can't really prep that. And actually the last few days I've been just juicing in the morning for my daily juice, so can't really show you too much prep. But here's what my day typically looks like. I wake up really early in the morning. I spend time with God and pray. I get some exercise in. If I have detox methods that I want to take care of for the day, I will do those. And then I will take a shower or I will start my food prep. One of those will happen. It just depends on what my detox method was. So if I got in the sauna because I'm all sweaty, I'll go ahead and get in the shower first and then go to the kitchen and start prepping my food. But if my detox method was something else that doesn't require me to be sweaty, I will go and make my food and then go take my shower and get ready for my day. But what I do typically is I'll make juices and smoothies in the morning, and I'll make a big salad. And so I know that if I have those things ready, then that's what I'm gonna eat. I happen to work at home, so all I have to do is stick that food that I prepped in the refrigerator. And yes, it does help me to prep my food even though I work from home. Most people who work from home tend to work more than they would if they actually worked outside of the house. That's unfortunate, but it's easy to get roped into doing that. And so you have to use your time management skills very well. But I don't always do that, so I will find time in that morning to carve out everything for the day. So when I get hungry for breakfast, I go in the kitchen and I will get whatever it is for breakfast. And usually it's one of three things. It's like fruit, a big bowl of fruit that I just cut up or just stuck in a bowl. Or I will have a big juice, which is 32 ounces for me, or I'll have a smoothie, which is 32 ounces for me, which is a liter, depending on where you are in the world. And not only do I make the food for me, but I make it for my husband too. He eats exactly what I eat unless he wants to go out and make a special trip to go get something that he wants to either make for himself or he buys at a restaurant. So I make those things for us both. And then I will make a salad or some type of vegetable dish or vegetable soup or something like that. and I'll make it, and I get everything done within an hour. So at the end of the day, when it's time to have dinner, all I either do is pull the bowl out of the refrigerator, and I usually separate it into two different bowls, give one to my husband, and I'll eat the other one. Or if I have made like a soup or a warm dish or something like that, I'll pull it out, put it on the stove, and heat it up. And it's just as simple as that. If I happen to work outside of the home, this is what I would do. I would have myself a cooler that I could either put my food in the refrigerator in the office, or I would have it in my car, in my trunk, in, you know, inside of with ice packs. That's what I would do. I'd put my food in there. When it was time for me to eat, I'd go outside, get my food, or go into the refrigerator and get my food and eat it. And my dinner, I would leave it at home. And when I got home, I would pull it out of the refrigerator and either eat it if it doesn't need to be cooked, or I would pull it out and heat it up and serve my family. That's what I would do if I was working outside of the home. The thing is that you have to set up in your mind that you want to succeed on these plans, because it is, our society has made it too easy for us to just go grab something that is convenient, but yet it's not good for our health. So you have to make it so that the things, the healthy foods that you want to eat, are convenient for yourself. Now, also, you didn't hear me talk about snacks, because typically I don't eat snacks. But if I am going to eat a snack, it's going to be, you know, a piece of fruit or two, maybe a handful of seeds or nuts or something like that. But I usually make big enough portions in my meals to where I don't need a snack. But if you know you're a person that needs a snack, then you should pack a snack. Even if you pack too much food or you make too much food, you can always eat it either later or the next day. So you have to make up in your mind that you are going to succeed, that you're not going to make these other choices. Don't leave yourself room to make other choices. Put all the parameters in place that will help you succeed. And then you have to do some examining of your own heart. Do you really want to succeed on this plan? Or really, are you just kind of trying it to see if it works? Because if you're just trying it to see if it works, it doesn't always work that way, because our natural tendency is to not do the inconvenient thing, which is to prep your food and be ready for the day. So you have to say in your mind, look, come heck or high water, this is what my plan is to do. This is what I want to do. And you have to have your reasons why you want to do it in front of you, so that you do make it a point to succeed. But if you don't want to succeed, I'm telling you, you can find 1,000 reasons not to. But if you want to succeed, do what you've got to do to succeed. And also, there are people who do what I do for multiple days. Like, it doesn't just have to be one day. You can do, you know, your food for 2 or 3 days. It doesn't have to be just the one day like I do. That just happens to work for me. You have to figure out what works for you and make it work for you. But like I said, in the change of the new year, I will be doing some food prep videos. Right now, I'm juicing. I just don't have anything to prep. So anyway, I hope y'all liked this video. If you liked it, please give it a thumbs up. Share it with a friend. Also, don't forget, the 90-Day Walk to Freedom from Fibroids group coaching program starts on Sunday, September 15th. If you want to join, I still have some spots available. And I will talk to y'all soon. Take care.